Hello friends, first I would like to thank all the management, principal of Ramanujan College for giving me an opportunity to interact with 1 week EDP on entrepreneurship, innovation and incubation. Friends, I take this privilege and honor to be among you. To share my experience. I'm Sudhakar Paul, working with Ambedkar University Incubation, Innovation and Entrepreneurship, an incubation center set up by Delhi government. And before this, I was with the Ministry of Food Processing, Institute called National Institute of Food Technology, Entrepreneurship and Management. And before that, I was with Central Institute for Rural Electrification. And I'm having almost close to 11 years of experience, hands-on experience, I can say, in terms of creating the entrepreneurs. And I would like to congratulate all the participants for taking this opportunity to be part of this program. And I'll be taking a session on business opportunity identification. And why we have to take this step before we start any business or a venture or a startup. And from 2014 onwards, the startup ecosystem has emerged and coming in a big way. And more startups are coming in India. And since India is good with the human capital, we have to make best use of it. I would also request people from all the teaching fraternity to take this complete program as a, one of the important tool in their life, because government has started giving some kind of leverages for the people who are working in the institution to have their own ventures. And I'm not sure about other government organizations, other states, but whereas in Delhi government has clearly given a guidelines that even faculty while working with the institution can also have their own ventures. All that they have to do is they have to intimate their parent organization that I am going to start my own venture or I will be having my startup. And apart from that, the faculty can also get the funding support from the college in case that college is having the incubation centers. So in days to come, I expect in other states, this opportunity will be opening up. So I request everyone to be part of this program interestingly, and probably you may have your own venture in days to come. I would love to help you in any area of your life in case if I can have. And before further delaying, I'll share my screen. I already told you I'll be talking about business opportunity identification and how to identify the business opportunity, why this is an important subject, and why we have to concentrate on this subject. Is just because this is the first and foremost step in starting any of the business. If you take this step with utmost care, then you will mitigate the chances of failure. You will mitigate the chances of reducing the risk. If we are not able to take the right strategy, right business opportunity, probably the chances of winning the game slightly reduces. And I already told you, I'm Sudhakar Paul. And this is a one-way interaction. So I would request you put all your questions in one piece of email. And you can write to me, sudhakar.aci@aud.ac.in. I will happy to reply to your email. And I would also like to get your calls in case if you have any query, and my mobile is displaying here. Before further delay, let's move to the next slide. The complete session I have divided into three parts. First, the do's and don'ts, what to do, what not to do, when to do, and what are the red flags that are popping up before we start any venture. And next session, I will be talking about the knowledge transformation. Whatever the knowledge that I earned during my career, I want to share. And I put as simple as it, the presentation is completely in a normal terminology. I'm not using any jargons of management jargons like typical words. I try to put as easy as possible. And the third session, we will be doing it as a kind of case study, or maybe how the business has transformed, or how some people has taken a business to a next level by doing their business opportunity assessment. How they have done it, what are the steps they have gone through, and how they are now today. So first we'll talk about do's and don'ts. So whenever you get an idea, we all are very excited. We all are very excited. I want to do it. I got this idea. I want to do it. It is going to be success. Yes, this is good. Your sixth sense says that, okay, you come across the awesome idea that will work. I am also with you. But slightly, what I will tell you is, hold back your excitement. Try to go back to your myths. Go back to your assumptions. You may be having that I developed this app, and this app can maybe aggregator between all the service provider. And a few days back, one of my friend came to me and started telling in South people consume rice more, and they don't know how to source the rice, the good quality of rice. I want to be aggregator. I told him, he came with the complete app and every structure was ready, and he wants to go live. And I told him, hold back. Don't jump into the solution. Try and understand what are the pain areas of your customer. And try understand whether they're needing the services or not. Then he immediately started telling, no, I spoke with my relatives. I spoke with my neighbors. I spoke with my friends. My third point is that, don't rely on your own people, because your own people will give you the obvious answers. And of course, they are the people who will be tell we are there in case if you fail. But before that, try to speak with real customer. Real customers as unknown as it could be. You just walk into your store and started speaking. Or maybe you walk into the shopping mall, started speaking, or just go to the door to door, go to the right target audience. Don't take the apple and compare with the orange. And you know who are the people who will be buying the orange, and you know who are the people who are buying the oranges. So go to the right set of target customer or prospective customers, and speak with them, whether they are really needing the service or not. And during last 6 to 7 years, we were able to see more service-driven organizations as well as the product-driven organizations. But the service-driven organizations are popping up a lot, because now India is emerging as a developing country and developed country. And people are ready to put money on the services also. So go with the right set of customers, try to speak with them and understand whether what is their real needs are. And it is good to speak with your own people, but I strongly recommend you should speak with the real audience. And I also told you that probably you may have some assumptions that, okay, this will work, people are needing it, and I come across this problem, so there may be many people who will be coming across that problem. You may be 100% right, but check before execution. And whatever I'll be sharing, it is purely on the experience based. And you can prove me wrong. Entrepreneurship is all about proving someone wrong. So it's not like you are supposed to do exactly this, but these are the best practices that can help you in increasing your success chances. And you all are ambassadors of entrepreneurship ecosystem. Directly or indirectly, we all are creating the wealth. And so we will all be calling ourselves as a wealth creators, directly creating a ventures or creating a pool of entrepreneurial mindset students. So take this as a pride and we will do it in a big way. And say big no to this short-term business model. What is a short-term business model? Probably it might not be with you for 360 days. Or maybe it might not last for maybe hours together. Or it might not long for maybe years together. For example, in some of the village festivals, you may be looking for some stalls where thousands of people come and you will be earning good money. It's okay. But what you will be doing the rest of the days? And entrepreneur is a person who will invest in the money, which will have the continuous in the cycle, continuous. The business has to be a recurring business. So I am not in favor of short-term businesses. Probably someone say that, okay, now the COVID time is, COVID is here and we all are living with it and we don't know how long we need to live it, but yes. And people have started coming with the good type of mask, the face shield and sanitizers. Okay, this is good. You may be grasping the opportunity. I'm not saying this is wrong. We are supposed to do it. But don't create complete your empire on the short-term business. I can still encourage anyone, if they have some kind of business and want to pivot during the opportunity whenever they are coming across, they can do that. Probably you are having the textile industry, maybe you are having the swing operating manpower. So you may be slightly, instead of going for the conventional stitching methods and conventional clothing, you can pivot it to maybe going with the mask, maybe PPE kits. It is okay. But don't create your venture only based on short-term business models. And another point what I want to mention here is, don't believe only on secondary data. And I request everyone, before you get into any of your ventures, try to validate the secondary data with your primary data. Recently, in late December, I was reading in newspaper like, I'm not sure, Zomato or Swiggy has published an article that biryani is the fastest consuming food item across India. By reading that, I'm telling, don't jump into, I will start my food business. What I'm telling you is, go where you want to start, choose the location, go and speak with your people and try to understand, are they really interested in your biryani or something else? Or probably you might come across some news articles saying that by 2020, the tourism industry will grow by 30%. By reading that, don't jumping into the tourism industry. Take that secondary data and go into the field and come out with your primary data. That will help you a lot. And this is everyone maybe telling that no idea is a big idea, no idea is a bad idea, no business is a bad business. That also I'm telling. And the another point I want to make is, don't create solution and don't create solution first and going to identify the problem. And this approach will limit yourself, will not give you ample of opportunities. Maybe you will be going with a very good product, but probably the necessity of the problem, necessity of the product may not arise in this business environment, or maybe someone else might also already there. So believe in blue ocean strategy. Try to be a problem to solution approach. Go and identify the problems and come out with the solutions. If you come from the problem areas, then you will be able to give the real product to your real customers with a real need. We will move to the next segment. It's called knowledge transfer. I want to share whatever I understand and I learned during my career. I already told you, if you have any queries, try to put it on a piece of paper and text it to me, and I am happy to answer. Now, the $1 million question. How to identify business opportunity? Few people may say that all of a sudden I got an idea and I have executed, I succeeded. But the percentage is very less. What I suggest you and your students, go where the problems are. You don't know what you want to do, but you are passionate about starting your own venture. Go and spend your time with the problems. Go where the problems are. If you go where the problems are, you will be able to excel in the venture. You will be excel in that purpose. If you go to where the facilities are, in any case, the facilities are already there, and probably you will also become one of the problem to the facility. Nothing more you will be able to add. But if you go to the problems, and problems will teach you the lessons. And believe me, most of the successful business was built on deep understanding your customers, deep customer insights. Because you are not the one who will be using that device, or you are not the one using that product. You're the customer who are going to use and are going to pay to the service or pay to the product. So whatever you want to develop, whatever you want to design, you have to go to that people and start explaining them why this is needed. And they will be able to tell you what are their problems. So where can I find the opportunity? In line with that, there are a few things I want to tell. Go to the people. maybe you want to create some big business to a middle class families, go and spend your time with middle class family. Speak with them. What are their needs? Live with them. Love them. Because when you start loving them, you will be able to connect with them. When you start living with them, when you put your foot into their shoe, you will be able to understand, oh, the problem I was able to see is the not at all a problem. Or problem I was able to see is not that small problem. It is big problem. And learn from them. What is the existing solution to the problem? Are they really seeing this as a problem? Or maybe they are not seeing it as a problem. And there will be the right person who will be telling you what their real needs are. Then try to study who are your competitors. Is there any business model available in the existing scenario? May not be to that problem, but in any other sector, in any other area where you can just pivot it. Study the competitors. Because they put their blood and sweat in understanding the customer needs, and they might come across some product or a service, and in that what you will be adding more, what value you will be going to add will change your or will be able to change their complete needs, or will completely solve the problems of your customers. While you're going or spending your time with your customers, try to observe three things at least. What are their jobs? What are their pains? What are their gains? What are the jobs they would like to perform? Whatever the struggles that they are going in their jobs, can I identify some product or a service to make their job simpler? If you see in older days, our grandmothers used to use firewood to cook. Over a period of time, the firewood stove came without smoke. And still in many of the rural, people are using still firewood. But some of the NGOs, some of the business ventures has given them now smokeless stove. So try to see what are their pains. What kind of pains they are going through? Am I become a pain reliever? Me or my problem or me or my product or my service can solve their pain? Or what are the gains that they are looking for? They're putting their 8 hours, but they were not able to get the handsome, decent amount. That's what happened before Ola or Uber popping up in India. The taxi drivers used to stand in a queue and hours together outside of the railway stations, bus stops to get their turn. Maybe in a day, maybe maximum they may be getting 2 or 3 turns. And they have to put their fuel, because one way you are able to get and the another way you are not having any service. So this was the problem, this was the pain that the Uber and Ola understood, and they were able to create a product or a service. So if you emphasize your if you concentrate on their jobs, pains and gains, you are able to crack the deal and none of the other people were able to meet your take over your business, because you are the person who were with them and who was come out with the problem and the problem or the product or the service with the real customers are looking for. How to select the right business opportunity? There are 6 steps that I have not put it in this presentation. Identify your business and personal goals. What are your business goals and personal goals? What you want to do? And I already told you, you have to research one thing about the problems, one thing about the customers, and you should also research about the particular industry. Probably it might be your favorite industry or the industry in which you identify the problems of the customers. And you should also see the what is the promising segments of the industry where you will be easily able to get your product or the service, getting into the market, and identify problem areas that I already told you. When you identify a problem areas, try to understand, try to brainstorm among all the problem areas. I'm sure none of us able to solve all the problems. Pick few problems, try to connect the dots, and you will be able to come out with the solutions. And never ever tell that this problem don't have a solution. Your problems, as more as problems you will see, as more as opportunities will pop up in your life. If you try to understand why this problem is coming and try to understand and brainstorm about the problem, you will come across many innovative ideas. And you should also see the possible solutions available and what else you can add into their life. And focus most promising opportunities. There are a few 2x2 matrix that I want to tell you, which can easily help you to understand whether you will be able to take, whether you are going to enter into the right business or not. This is called BCG growth share matrix or BCG matrix. You can tell. Generally, this will be used for the investment purpose. This can also be used for starting your own venture. And in the x-axis, you will see the market share. In the y-axis, you will see a market growth. So when there is low and low, where the market share is low and market growth is low, probably it is not wise decision to invest online. And whereas that we can, that this matrix is indicated as a dog. And next to dog, we see cash cow, where the market share is very high, market is growth is very low. But when the market share is very high, you can get your money quickly. And you can get best out of this business, because soon this market share is going to come down, and this business will become the business like a indication like a dog. So you have to quick enough and get as much as possible and invest in either question mark or in the star, because Star is the first preference because it is having a high market share and high market growth. And the next preference, you can give it to the low market share and high market growth. And where probably you are not sure how it is going to be, but still there is high possibilities. High possibilities of growing the market market growth and probably for the time being, market share might be low and you may not be sure, but this will also help you in identifying your business opportunity, whether you are doing it in right or not. You put your business opportunities into 2x2 matrix, you will be able to get your answer. Then this is one of the old analysis that we know, the SWOT analysis: strength, weakness, opportunities and threats. This can also help you